A complete graph is a graph where there is an edge between each two parallel vertices. For example, here is the complete graph with 3 vertices, named K3, the one with 4 vertices, named K4, the one with 5 vertices, named K5, and if we continue like that, we get this amazing animation. And today, I want to show you how I made it in Python. Obviously, this animation is a sequence of images that represent complete graphs with an increasing number of vertices. We first have the one with 3 vertices, then 4, then 5, and so on. So, we first need to make a function that generates an image of a complete graph of size n. Then, we call it with different values of n, from 3 to 70 for example, and we get the different frames of our animation. Let's start. To be able to plot a complete graph of size n, we first need to calculate the coordinates of its vertices, and for that, we'll use some trigonometry. Let's suppose that we have a circle centered at x0, y0 with a radius of r, and we want to calculate the coordinates of a point at its edge, for example, this one. To do so, x is x0 plus r times cosine of alpha, and y is y0 plus r times sine of alpha. But what's the relation with a complete graph? It's true that the vertices of a complete graph can be anywhere, but to get a beautiful and symmetric result, we will put them on the edge of a circle as you can see, and we will use what we've seen now to calculate the coordinates. We can center our circle at the position 0, 0, so x0 and y0 will be 0. And for the angle, let's analyze the angles of vertices of this complete graph of 5 vertices. We have a circle of 180 degrees. The vertex 0 is at degree 0. The vertex 1 is at degree 36, which is 1/5 of 180. The vertex 2 is at degree 72, which is 2/5 of 180. The vertex 3 is at degree 108, which is 3/5 of 180. And the vertex 4 is at degree 144, which is 4/5 of 180. So in general, the vertex I is at degree I divided by n times 180, where n is the total number of vertices. 180, which is 2π if we work in radians. We deduce that to calculate coordinates of vertices, we traverse values of I from 0 to n-1, we calculate the angle, we calculate x and y, and we add them to the array of vertices. In code, our function takes as parameters the number of vertices and the radius. We create an array of vertices, then for I from 0 to n-1, the angle is I divided by n times 2π. To calculate x, we do r times cosine angle, and we round the result to 2 decimals for example. For y, same thing, but we use sine instead of cosine. And we add the couple xy to our array. After the loop, we return vertices as a NumPy array. As a NumPy array because it's easier to work with when using the pyplot module, which will be the case. Okay, now we calculated coordinates of vertices, but we need to plot them. For that, we will use matplotlib pyplot module. For a complete graph of size n, we start by creating a figure of equal height and width. We hide axes because we don't need them, and we calculate coordinates of the n vertices. Now, we plot them with a scatter method. We need to provide the array of x's and the array of y's. This is why I pass the first and the second column of our NumPy array. I also set white as the color. Now we plotted the vertices, but we need to also plot the edges of the graph. We have an edge between each two vertices, so we traverse all the couples ij, and for each couple, we plot the line. X's are v of I of 0 and v of j of 0, and y's are v of I of 1 and v of j of 1. The color is also white. We finish plotting the graph, we save the result as an image whose name depends on n, and we close the figure. Now in our main function, we repeat this process for all the sizes that we want, from 3 to 70 inclusive for example, and we get our images. Last thing to do, we create a video with them. For that we will use the CV2 module. We create an array of images, then for each file, we read the file, we extract the width and the height, and we insert the image in our array. After doing so, we use video writer of CV2 module, where we write each image. After it, we just use release and we get our video that you can watch again and again. We've reached the end of this video. If you're interested by this kind of animations, please tell me in comments. And if you enjoyed, like and subscribe to the channel. See you in the next one.